welcome everybody to the science track. And the first talk of the track will be by Andreas Tille on Debian science.
Yeah, thank you. Well, I was recently asked how many DebConfs I attended. I was counting, and this is the 11th DebConf I'm attending, and it's really nice. And in 2003, I was the first time talking about something like Blends. It was not named like this, and I was always addressed as a man who was talking about Blends and science. And at this DebConf, the first time I'm addressed as somebody else, I'm addressed as a man who's taking the photos. And this is kind of a different kind of getting famous. So, what I want to tell you today, it's about the current status of Debian science, and I would like to explain my ideas how we could to get even better support of sciences by using the Blends techniques even better, and I would also like to discuss some problems we have in Debian science, which are coming up from time to time. Well, the history is like, well, I told you I was on several DebConfs. I also visited DebConf 5 in Finland, and it was, well, maybe the start was given by Helen Faulkner in a talk, which ended up we create a mailing list where we discuss topics of scientists inside Debian. Then some competing packaging teams evolved. Some people started with packaging scientific computation and so on. We have different teams, and it was not really clear who is who and who is packaging something else. And so the teams finally were merged in quite an effort and some flamish discussions. And this was more or less ended in 3 years ago. And we are using this Blends framework, which was invented for Debian Edu, Debian Med, and so since 2008. Who is familiar with the term Blends? Please raise your hands. Okay. Who has not raised his hand? Okay. That's good. So we have a complete set now. Well, a blend is something which is definitely completely inside Debian. It's no derivative. The funny thing is, always if I talk about blends and I have these slides, which is in boldface, no derivative. In the end, I get the question, why are you doing a Debian derivative to do science? No, I don't. I never had an idea because I'm personally definitely convinced that if we do things inside Debian, if we adapt Debian itself to a specific purpose, then we have in the end way more less work on the long run. In the short term, it's very easy to take Debian, add some scientific stuff and be done. That's a quick and dirty approach. A blend is simply going over all the hurdles you might face in Debian, make it properly and have it done in the long run. So it's about forming a packaging team about around the topic. Well, derivatives are frequently done by a single person. And this single person has usually quite low running over by boss factor. In the best case, this person has children. Having children is cutting quite a lot from your spare time, and this person will not be able to continue with the derivative, and the derivative died. I've seen this with so many derivatives in the field I'm observing quite closely, which is biology and medicine. So you have countless derivatives of Debian. It's the most derived distribution, but a blend is doing a derivative the right way and don't derive, but do it inside Debian. We have developed some tools. It's kind of advertising the topic that we are doing it, so you can tell the world Debian is doing something about science. And we have also tools which are helping to do some quality assurance on science packages. It's called the Web Sentinel. I will show parts of the web sentinel, depending how much time we have, depending on how much questions you have. And this should help on advertising and quality, ensuring bug fixing and so on. In my eyes, Deviant Science is in so far a specific blend because science is not a defined topic, right? So many people can define themselves as scientists, and the fields of science are very wide. So in principle, my idea about Deviant Science is that it's only an umbrella to be a spin-offs, to have smaller topics, like we had, for instance, one famous offspring is Debian Astro. There were some astronomers inside Debian who are working in the Debian science team, and at one point in time, after I was nagging a lot, please do it yourself, they created an own blend, and this is now very successful. They have gathered a team of 10, 15 people who are working closely on the topic of astronomy. This would not have happened if they would not have formed a specific team, because astronomers all over the world use Debian but are not aware that they can bring in their own work into Debian by working with the Debian Astro team. Well, for a brand, a successful brand, you need a critical mass on one hand of packages and on the other hand of maintainers doing the work. And it's a very good thing if not only one maintainer works on one package, but at least two or three maintainers. And this is also kind of a team building inside a blend. And this blends framework should help to create this critical mass. If you see, oh, we have this list of packages, this is interesting, this one is missing, I can do something to fill this missing gap and I join the team. That's basically the idea. What specific blends do we have? As I said, I'm working for Debian Med. I actually initiated this project and I started with all these techniques, which I also adapted from other blends like Debian Edu and Debian GIS. We have also Debian GIS. This is about geographical information systems. We have DebiChem for chemistry. They existed in parallel to Debian Science and were not really offsprings, but as I said, Debian Astro is a real offspring from Debian Science, which really followed the idea I have. So what I would like to see is a list of 10 more of these blends, say Debian Mathematics, Physics, Electronics, Robotics, whatever we have. But currently, there's not a sufficient amount of maintainers who could form a team. You should start maybe with three or four people who are running this strongly, and then the other people will come and join you. At least this happened. So why it's not more? As I said, the idea of Debian Pure Blends leads... Yeah, there's a question. Can you please use the microphone? No, it's for the video recording. There's a microphone.
Sorry, I just care about... it's not that I only care about that, but I particularly care about NeuroDebian.
Yeah, NeuroDebian.
Yeah, is it also one of the blends like that? Is it like the same as all the others?
Well, I think NeuroDebian is a potential blend. They are working together in the Debian Science team. They have meta packages in Debian Science. They are working also together with the Debian Med team. But I think NeuroDebian is a perfect topic, which is a kind of close topic but it's only maintained by two very, very active people. It's Michael Hanke and Jaroslav Halchenko. They are doing a lot of work, but in my opinion, they should try to gather more people and use the framework themselves to advertise their stuff. They developed interesting techniques, which are different than what we are using. We should merge them into the Blends framework. For instance, they have a kind of... backporting system, they're backporting for every Debian release and Ubuntu release. This is quite cool stuff, but it's not really integrated. And so a blend is integrated, and I talk to them several times, please do so. And yes, if you are more convincible than me, then I would be really happy. So this was the answer to the question. Other questions? So I continue. The advantages are widely unknown. This is, at least, as I told you, this is one effect why the blends topic never goes in the main hall, because if other developers would know about how to organize their team or their topic in a blend, I think it would be more known, even if I'm talking about it. And I have a video proof. This is Ashish Laroya. Many people will know him. He quoted, or there's a quote in the video at about minute 33. We should try hard to run around asking users and developers, is there a topic you care about, and create a blend today. This was in 2013, and I asked him, Tim, 2015, did you ever create a blend? Oh, no, I didn't. And yes, but it's work, actually, right? You need to do some work. There was some time when I even did the work for other teams. For instance, I remember, I think it was in Edinburgh or so, for the Debian Games team, where there was a Debian Games talk running. And I was sitting in the talk, and I was creating all the meta packages we are using, and it was finished in 45 minutes and presented them the work, and they grabbed it up 2 years later, and now there's also this framework for Debian Games. Well, you're smiling. 2 years it's no time. Well, we are developing slowly. This is one release cycle, so it's not bad. It's good. If they do it, it's good. One release cycle is an appropriate time, and you need people who are just doing the work. But if you do it, you see more people are coming. And I'm doing team matrix graphics, and you see that if people are continue to use it, more people are coming. I can prove this statement on some graphs. I can show them later if you want. And the idea, to come back to Debian Science, to be an umbrella should be more better advertised. So from time to time, I'm posting to the Debian Science mailing list, please. Well, you are some people who are working for, say, robotics. You could do your own blend. Next question.
So I guess one point where I haven't been sort of motivated to really participate in this is, I think I'm maybe, you know, could be disconnected from the target audience, but I sometimes think of myself as a mathematician, and the idea of a meta package for all of mathematics doesn't even really make sense to me. So do you have feedback from various user groups that these meta packages are really useful, or, people tend to be focused on one or two applications that they need for their work. I don't know. It seems like maybe you want to sell me on this concept.
Well, I agree with you that sometimes a hard decision how to categorize packages. This can only be done by, in the example of mathematicians, by mathematicians. And it's always kind of, gut feeling how to do it. In general, the task or the meta packages are overloaded by programs you will not use, but who cares about disk space these days? And you can be sure that you really install everything what's covering the topic, if it's more or less designed. In Debian Med, we make it very, very simple. We put close to everything which is biology related into one meta package, and it's installed. You have lots of packages which are not really needed, but for the first installation, we have in my institute, we have 50 users who are using one machine. They are using quite different programs. And once you install Med Bio, you are sure everything's installed for them. This is not always the application you might have in mind, because you're running your own machine and you know what you need. But it's for people who don't know. And also, if I'm going to this page, this is the biology task. It's also for advertising what we have. So if you want to explain any mathematician what kind of mathematics programs are inside Debian, then you point them to, well, say it takes a Debian science topic, mathematics, and you can show what's inside Debian. I don't have no idea how many packages it is. And if you get add more structure to this very general mathematics, it's quite long here, I don't know. You have a lot of packages, right? And for instance, I think this one, this GeomView is just an education tool. You don't need in numerical analysis or so, yeah? So you would find some better structure, and you can use these pages as an advertising of what we have. So these pages are answering the question, what you are doing in Debian, what can I expect from Debian? It's not only about installing this, it's also about showing what we have. Or you see, we have screenshots. And also a very good argument, I think it's going back to the Debian Milzing, we have citations here. So if you want to approach upstream, I want to package your nice software. Well, upstream is not cooperating. It's, for instance, not setting any tags which are helping you, and all this not willing to at the license. They said, well, what's our offer to you? We provide your publication amongst other one in a kind of a structures context. He sees an application close to other relevant programs. He sees how many users are using this program. You can see a screenshot. You can have translation. We have also some upstreams have some registration for their program to know how many people are using it. We can also link this here. If we have the metadata, we can put it here. We can, the thing is that with the blend, you can go from a single package view to a group of package view with all the metadata connected in one place. And I think this is kind of an advantage. This is not only the installation side, but only the inside to provide proper information and attract people and connect people like developers and users. It is a proper answer to your question.
So I think, yeah, there's a few important points that you mentioned. And I think to stress, I mean, to motivate developers to stress what's the value beyond the package descriptions, which already exist. I mean, we're mostly pretty expert at finding what we want in Debian. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And to point out, you know, some of this sort of curation aspect.
Yeah, yeah, of the it's metadata, a curation. Yeah, you have the string search in apt-get search or apt-get search, or you have Xapian index also. But the string search is not always helpful. This is a curated list.
I mean, one thing we all want to avoid is just work which doesn't have obvious benefits, right? So we should really stress.
Yeah.
To you know, compile this metadata is an extra task,
yeah.
And to maintain these tasks is an extra task. So
yeah.
Somehow we need to.
Technically, this list is generated only from package names. You just need package names. So the task list has package names, and the framework extracts all this information from UDD. So this is done automatically. Okay, next question.
My question is there a concept of a PopCon for the blend itself?
For the meta package itself, or what?
Correct.
Yeah. Yes, it's a normal package show, so you have PopCon, but I never minded about it. Oh, sorry. I minded about this data. Yeah, it's a good question. Yeah.
Just be be nice if users did that, because back to David's
point. We could add this. Maybe I should make a mental note, yes. Yeah. I would also love to have some popcorn data, maybe from Ubuntu also, because we have a lot of derivatives who are using these packages, and maybe it would be also some extra information. I do not really want to advertise Ubuntu here on this page, but it's some relevant information about the package. Do you know something? Oh, can you?
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, more thinking about it could be interesting thinking about the popcorn and similar to see. I don't think there's a way to do it, but to correlate who has how many cases of having a high percentage of OneBlend's cases installed. Mm. Versus how many times the blend itself as a full meta package is installed.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. I've not thought about this idea,
A bit strange to put it this way, because one of the issues I was thinking maybe is that a blend installs, say, you were this is about bio, but biology spans so many subfields that many people will want 1, 2, 3 of the packages, not all of it.
I fully agree. Well, my point is, I was nagging my fellow Debian Med members to do the categorization. I'm a physicist, right? I'm just not competent to do more fine-grained categorization. I would love if somebody would do it, and there is some work ongoing and thinking, but it also will take us one or more release cycles, so ask me again in 4 years, and then maybe. I even thought about splitting Debian Med and Debian Bio, because this could force this categorization. My original idea was inspired by the critical mass of developers and packages to put both together, because bio is very closely related to medicine. I'm working in a medical institute, but we are basically using the biological packages and no practice management. So this had some advantage in the beginning, and we never went away from this. But you are fully right.
I also, well, not really a question, but a comment. I mean, this is web-based, and now we have the situation that newer desktops like GNOME don't really you don't present the menu that we used to have. So back then in the GNOME 2 setting, there was this applications menu, and then you would have signs, and people would be easy to discover actually the applications which are installed via the tasks. And now with GNOME, it's a bit more difficult. You just have to type stuff in, and it shows up. So is there any way to get this overview on the desktop, in a sense, like starting either Greeter or maybe packaging it locally as a package inside the blends?
Well, no. I think the answer is, in the beginning, when I started writing the framework, I was writing some blends own menu system with a Debian menu, this menu system, but it's not used anymore.
Right.
So this should be ported to Free Desktop, and then the problem would be solved.
Right, then I guess you have the problem that these menus are not really exposed anymore, right?
So
you have these applications, and if you if you type the Windows button on a GNOME screen, then you just have a input thing, and this is all not very discoverable. So
yeah,
maybe
but it's a GNOME problem, I think.
Well, yeah, but that's
I don't use it.
Desktop.
I don't want to make a flame button.
You should think about the standard desktop.
No.
Just tested, but I've seen you can integrate the GNOME Software Center into that search, so you get packages that are not installed. So you search for a package.
Mm.
I don't know if it's really helpful to do a full text search there, but maybe that's something. Maybe if you just use the tags, so that is maybe some packaging tasks that GNOME package maintainers can look into.
Yeah. Well, I think, to some extent, GNOME is using the Free Desktop Org data, and we should also rely on this standard. And
obviously,
the implementation is not our problem, because we are doing package categorization and not desktop developer. At least we have no manpower to do this.
No, but my point is that additionally, it would be useful to have something for users which is discoverable. So for example, Enrico showed me a tool which is kind of like a small GUI with buttons on it for all the packages, which I think in that case was a specific tag because he was doing it prototyping dev tags. So there could be this one central place where you could launch all the packages from one task from a small GUI, and you just tell people, oh, run this tool, and then you can see all of 55 biological things. And or I think really we should try to package offline the website and just have it as a starting screen in Firefox or something. Or at least something which the people have on the hard disk, and then because those websites are beautiful, but people have to actually find them.
So that's correct.
I mean, you know, you use
them. I tell them, and I'm using them because
but
you have
Matt Bio, and who's not you?
I point sometimes people to it too, because you see the translate description. This everything with this yellow means work. So you can click on this, and then you go to a page where you can translate this description. And if you have a translated one, then this, then you can say here below, this is translated. I have German local here, and then you can only fix the translation. But the yellow button is vanished because it's done. And here you can also use dev tags. Oh, I can use this one. Or edit dev tags if you have some. So this is some interactive to some extent. It's not JavaScript, and so it's simple. But it should show where users can do some work. Ah, and by the way, what I forgot regarding PopCon, the additional information which PopCon provides, if you have very similar programs, you can maybe sort according to PopCon and see, the most people are using this of all the similar things, and so this is also information. So I think I continue from here. Okay. So, as I said, Blends are providing some kind of a straightforward access to the package pool. And you have no real need to search for interesting packages because it's just collected for you. And we try to get some engagement to package more free scientific software. For instance, you could do some menus or so. It's also on my slides. Or you could do some installer for. So you use a normal Debian installer, and then you get a selection list. So you want Debian Edu, Debian Science, Debian Meet or so. We were very, very close to get this implemented. This is the idea from 2003. For Stretch. And then somebody said, well, you implemented this wrongly, and it was dropped the feature. So we were very close to say install Debian Science, yes, but we need another release cycle at least. Very sad. Anyway, so the Web Sentinel I have shown you, and I can show you the bugs overview, for instance, for Science Mathematics. Should go to Debian Science. So this bugs overview shows you the following. There is some kind of logic behind this this color scheme. So in red highlighted tasks, you find a lot of bugs. In the green, it's orange, reddish, and green is nearly nothing, and in yellow, so we check just economics, no idea what it is. And you see here also some color schemes. The more reddish ones are the release critical bugs, and the yellowish ones are the important bugs, and the green ones are not. So there's a legend on top. So you can see, with this color scheme, you can lead people working on some field to this page. And if they are interested to help you, then they have quite a different view on the bug tracking system than they have otherwise. So they find the bugs they might be interesting for them. This is the idea of this bugs overview. And we have this so-called Thermometer. It's kind of a list which tells you in what release, it's what version, and in backports, and so you can look at it on later on the web. And we have this maintainer statistics. I have one example on the slide, so you can see it later here. So my point is that Debian should more actively reach out to upstream, not only taking some software and do it, but actively reach out to upstream. For instance, use a free license, use a versioning, and something else. And so it makes a difference. If you are a random person, like Andreas Tille, who's Andreas Tille? I never heard about this guy. Or I'm writing to you as a member of the Debian Science team. Okay, there's a team, Debian, I've heard about Debian, and they care for science. It's a totally different position if you approach upstream, and the chances that they respond to you are just higher. So as I said, we advertise upstream publications, we can link to their registrations, provide PopCon statistics, and so we give credit to upstream. It's important because, well, scientists are, yeah, sometimes a little bit focused on their very specific stuff and don't care about the world around. That's not bad. It's helpful for their science, but to get the connection between the upstream and the user, we are the missing link.
Do you track website hits for the Web Sentinel? I mean, so you can tell upstream, okay, like 20,000 people looked at the MetBio task.
No, I don't track this. No, I don't track this. So I realize that the screen is not adjusted properly. So I have a list of some specific meta packages. The list is a little bit longer than here. My slides do not fit. It doesn't matter. We have these meta packages in science. It's you see, for instance, brain-computer interface is quite different from chemistry or electrophysiology. So we have a lot. I also don't know what financial engineering is. We can look at the tasks. So I just made a list, okay? And we have another. It's about 30 tasks. It could be more because there are more sciences, but these are the tasks somebody is caring about. This is just a point. This is not a very strict selection what we have, because we have nobody who really can curate the full list. As I said, I'm not competent. What I'm doing is sometimes I'm checking what package is maintained by a member of the Debian Science team according to the maintainer of the package, and if the package is listed in our tasks. I have a UDDs query, and before we are releasing, I'm sending an email. Readers of Debian Science will have seen this kind of mails. Please categorize your package, because you know in what category it would fit. And one package can fit in more than one category. It's not exclusive, definitely not. And I want people to do this. And we have some common science utilities, like this data acquisition, accessing devices, distributed computation, and presentation with always with science in mind, right? It's not general presentation tools. And so this is quite helpful. And we have also according development tasks. In principle, every task could have a development task, which is basically the development libraries, Python modules, and so on. And some sciences defined this, and others didn't. So it's completely self-organized, this task creation. I have no better solution for this, because otherwise one person needs to know the whole package pool, and my focus is not really Debian Science, but more Debian Mail, so I can't solve this. So the problem is that many developers are not really aware that Debian Science exists. So single maintainers are ITP in scientific software, and I'm checking all the ITPs, and I redirect them to Debian Science list. If you are reading the list, you will see from time to time, please join the Debian science team with your ITP. And it is frequent that some single maintainers, or it's not frequent, but it just happens that single maintainers don't care for their packages and they are featuring RC bugs. And they either affect scientific packages because these are pre-dependencies, or they are scientific packages but not maintained by the Debian science team. And so what I'm doing is pinging the maintainer, and if he doesn't respond, I'm team hijack the packages. Team hijack means, well, I would like to put your package into Debian Science team, and if I don't hear from you after 2 weeks, I will do the work and do it. It's well, it's conflicting with Debian policies because we have this maintainer ownership of the package, but nobody of the maintainers blamed me about this. I had some package which was before the Jesse release. I had 24 hours to save it into the Debian Mate team, and I set the limits. If I don't hear you after 24 hours, I will do this, and I did it. Saved the package for Jesse. He never heard from the maintainer, but some third person blamed me. You should not do this. It's hijacking. I agree, I should not do it, but it was helpful for the users in the end, so what should I say? And developers don't really care for the tasks, and this is a UDD query I'm doing usually to see, oh, there is a scientific package which is not categorized, and I do some suggestion, something I can do myself, but some maintainers respond and some don't. It's volunteer-based, right? So this is, it's stupid. And next talk, I need to adjust this better. I'm badly prepared. The thing is, we have a graph from Debian Science team. Please assume numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 here. And it is showing these 420 packages have commits only from a single maintainer. And we have 280 packages which are touched by two maintainers. We have three, and this graph is somehow, well, hyperbolic style. So this means it's a bad team. I show you a good team. This is Packagy Perl. They have, I can tell you, 150 packages only by one maintainer, 400 by two maintainers, and close to 900 which are maintained by at least three persons. And this is a good team because a lot of people are caring. David? The microphone? I'm sorry for the bad display. I need to adjust it somehow.
So maybe I missed this, but how do you gather this data? Are you using uploaders field or changelog?
This is a version control system. I'm parsing Git.
Ah, great.
Of some teams, not of all teams. So and this is from Git.
Okay, thanks.
And for Debian Science from Git and S4N, because both is used. Another question? You wasn't?
That was my question.
Okay, yeah. So this is all around this blend stuff and team matrix. I'm gathering different sources of information, mailing lists, UDD uploads, version control system, and try to do some relations. One last hint, because in Debian Mate team we are not really here, but we have also quite many packages which have two maintainers. But I know from my own work that there was formerly one maintainer, and then I took over. So this second maintainer is only just me, and so it's in the end only a single maintainer. So this graph is not always right, but likes to show the pattern. You can see all the graphs on, well, I link every year to this in the Debian devel list and Debian project list, but you can ask me and I show you all the graphs of all the teams I have. So the problem with scientific software is that you have frequently short-term contribution by scientists because scientists frequently driven by projects with a limited time frame, 2-3 years or so, and then even upstream vanishes, and you need to upgrade the package or the program and adapt to new GCC versions, which is currently up to date. So we have also quite specific software. So there was a lot of effort to package some software from developed at CERN, which was done by a single maintainer, and this single maintainer now is also not available anymore. It was some Chinese name. I forgot the name, but we had done a lot of work, and we really need to make sure on the Debian Science team that this work is not lost and save these packages, even if it's complex, but it was really good. Yeah, and sometimes you have old libraries, Fortran and so on, yeah. So the point is, or the solution would be, that we should try harder to get more than one uploader. This is definitely goal, and I think one way to do it is to involve more upstreams from the software. This would be really cool. So then we have the effect of so-called team orphan packages. Whoops, this is... We need to salvage these packages, I mean, and the thing with this team orphan package, so what I mean is we have as maintainers a mailing list, and the uploaders are a number of real persons, and if none of these persons is not active anymore, the package is de facto orphaned. So, but it's way easier to do a team upload than a non-maintainer upload. Non-maintainer upload is always, you should not do it, or there's a barrier. And the team, you just fire up dch --team and you upload. I have also to make the concept of blends more known, invented the concept of sponsoring of blends. So I have a wiki page and said if you need a sponsor. So sponsoring concept is known. You are not a Debian developer and are not able to upload. I'm a Debian developer. I have the power to upload and I can help you, but I will only help you if you show that you understood the concept and if your package is inside the task packages and you have read the documentation of the blend and it shows up on the web Sentinel. This is my requirement to sponsor your package. And so I was able to help others because usually the newcomers are seeking desperately for a sponsor and I provide it. And so we can kill two birds with one stone. The package gets sponsored and the sponsee knows the blends concept. This was quite well received in the Debian GIST team. And it helped a lot of quite active Debian Science members who hopefully will be soon Debian developers and save me the work. And yeah, there's a wiki page. Okay. And the last question is Debian Science doing a bad QA? I think the problem is we have 1,000 packages and you always find 50 packages with bugs because it's a lot. So, and we are frequently blamed that's not dealt with these bugs, but yeah, it's just because you are a lot. And if you are really bored by the bug, this is the solution. dch--team, do a team upload. And this, as I said, the barrier is way lower than in NMU. So anybody who's blaming us about this can do something. So, last slide. If you want to do some maintenance of scientific software, just contact us. And it would be better to do it inside the team. And if you find you found somebody that is maintaining similar software like you, you can leave the umbrella of Debian Mate and do your separate blend. This is, for me, it's kind of an important point of this talk. Yeah, so you find the talk. If you Google for Andreas Thiele talks, it is written here. Sorry for that. It's at people.debian.org, Thiele at talks, and then you can find these slides, and I will enhance them a little bit. So I think I've done. Some questions? Thank you.
Here, are there further questions?
Questions in the middle. I like this because it's more lively. So
there was There was one question from IRC. Can you install two plants, e.g. geography and geology? Because there is a set of...
I can answer short. Yes, yeah. You can. You can install Debian games, Debian Junior, Debian Science on one machine. It's just meta packages. And per definition, packages who are optional should not conflict to each other. So, yes.
Any other questions? Okay, there's also the science buff at the end of the track where maybe if you have a question until
Yeah, to advertise the science buff, I have not prepared a lot of slides for the science buff. It's just about discussing, bringing in your ideas and, yeah.
Right, so there's a lunch break now and we'll reconvene with a talk on bioinformatics at 2:30, I guess. So, yeah, thanks again, Andreas, and see you later.
Yeah, see you.